We have to talk about, how did we meet though? Do you remember this? I tried remembering this.
How we met?
We probably met through a friend. Mutual friends.
Yeah.
Yeah. But tell me, you know, one of the best parts that I remember, like where we sort of, where I transitioned from like your friend to like a close friend, I was like, this one that's going to stay.
I know what you
mean. Is when like, I realized you're fiercely protective about people in your life.
Yeah.
Where does this come from?
I don't know. I feel like, you know, a lot of people don't stand up for themselves or, you know, they feel... what?
She's making me sound like somebody who doesn't stand up for myself.
No, no, you do stand up for yourself. But I feel like there are some situations
where... Yeah, but I don't. I fuck up a little bit.
No, I feel like there are times where people aren't as... I don't know. And it's not like when I stand up for someone, I'll like be aggressive to someone else.
Yeah.
I will just stand up for that person. I don't know. I really love and care about a lot of people in my life. And
yeah.
I trust that they do too.
Yeah.
And I just don't like seeing people that I love taken for granted. Or yeah. like, you know, just being said things to just because they don't say much and, you know... I don't know. I feel like there's too much hate in the world. People just need to be happy and people yeah. need to know that some things are not okay to be said.
Yeah.
And they need to be told that in a respectful, stern manner.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, see, the thing is, your mother and I've been chatting a little bit and she categorically told me not to tell you that I've asked you to ask her this. But now that I've said it...
My mother asked you to ask me something.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. So now she asked me to ask you, what are the similarities between her, your real mother, and Tabu's character in Jawani Jaane Man?
I cannot even begin to tell you. I remember when, after I got the film...
Have you been asked this before? No.
No.
Okay.
After I got this, after I got the film and then they gave me the script so I could read through the whole thing, I read through it and the parts I was... dying laughing at were Tabu ma'am's parts because without giving away too much because I wish I could quote lines from you know the film but because she's a very hippie and you know like she'll say things about the universe and other things and my mother recently has become very you know not recently it's been quite a while actually she's very like you know the universe and energies and things and
you know? The coolest moment that I have with her is when like one day at your place one of the first time I met her and I was like Pooja bhai and she was like you can call me Pooja auntie I don't mind it and I was like okay
yeah, yeah. She enjoys all this Pooja auntie and whatever she's a character
so little hippie vibe is going on
the hippie
especially
vibe
now that she lives in Goa and all of that
now she lives in Goa also more so yeah they have a lot of similarities lot
apart from all of this she also gave me very very morbid piece of information which I was quite surprised by
what is your mother like,
she told me listen you're not surprised that she types like this she's quite capable of saying things like this she told me do you want me to tell you the song that would be played at my funeral
oh yeah why did she why
I don't know and she told me this in context of this episode that we're shooting do you know the song
My Way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I don't know the reason why she brought this up.
How
she was like, do you want me to tell you this?
And mother,
like,
why?
Okay.
What, mother?
But fun. Tell me about the friends that are in your life.
Mm-hmm.
Because I feel like there are a few that are that have been there for years and years.
Yeah, yeah.
And then you're also pretty social. You make friends pretty quickly, but you also... quite judgmental about it. You
not
sort of
judgmental.
Like, I mean, as in like you sort of wait out a little bit and then let them into your life to the close territory and stuff.
See, when
like
I let someone into my life like properly, then I assume that they're there for the long haul. You know, I don't like making temporary like 5-minute friends.
Yeah.
I'm social. Yeah. I'm friendly with a lot of people. People I consider my close friends are very selective.
Yeah.
I've had friends like since the time I was born till like now. I've had friends, you know, a lot of my friends I've known for over a decade.
Yeah.
A lot of my close friends. And you know, I'm not many decades old at all.
Yeah.
I'm like 2 decades old and a little more.
Yeah.
But
decades are centuries.
Centuries? Where I'm centuries?
You know.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. Oh God.
One day you've told me. I mean, now you will beg to differ. One day, we are in the car and it's about to be 2020. And I'm like, this is the end of a decade. And she's like, a century. And I'm like,
no.
Huh?
No, this and is like, what happened. I saw an Instagram post that said, oh, wow, we're changing into a new millennium. So that's what I said to you. I was like, and then obviously I realized. And I looked at Renal, I was like, because I want to see his reaction. I want to see if he'd fall for it. Because a bunch of people in the Instagram comments were falling for it. And then people were realizing. So I was like, oh, Renal, you know, 2020, we're going to a new millennium. And then he was like, no, Baba, century.
No, I actually,
and I was like,
I thought about it for 5 seconds.
Millennium. No, then you were like, no, Baba, century. And I was like,
shut up. I never said century.
This is what happened. Okay, he was like, no, Baba, century. And I was like, acha. And then I was like, no, Renal, decade. And you were like, ha, decade. Oh, you are so dumb, even you fell for it. This is what actually happened. You can beg
me like a reverse slap.
Slap your nonsense. Exactly what happened. Renal twists things and does things.
Anyway, that's fine. That's fine.